Welcome out to the park at St. Mary's University in San Antonio, Texas for the championship series of the 2019 Heartland Conference Tournament. Anders Dossmeister, good to be back with you once again here on the third and final day of this invitational. The Lubbock Christian Lady Chaps take on the Oklahoma Christian Eagles. Lubbock Christian 32-18, Oklahoma Christian 37-14. These two teams have played once in this tournament. It was a very good competitive game yesterday. Look forward to nothing short of that here today. The scenario works like this. The Eagles win once. They are Heartland Conference champions. They are moving on to the NCAA tournament in Division II for the first time in program history. Lubbock Christian, they have thoughts of trying to find a way to win two games here today to move on and win this Heartland Conference tournament for the third time in program history. Once again, a matchup of brothers Shannon Hayes and Darren Hayes, the Oklahoma Christian head coach, the Heartland Conference Coach of the Year in his first season with 406 college softball wins. Darren's got 395 of them. He has had himself quite a role at that. Lineup card looks like this. The starting pitcher for Oklahoma Christian is the freshman Callie Crandall, first team all-conference player. Behind her, it will be a solid defensive lineup. Sierra Schultz is the catcher. Schultz had the walk-off hit yesterday at first base. Kaylee Upton. Second base, Bree Dunkel. At shortstop, it'll be Bridget White. Third base is Bailey Strecker. In left field, Lindsey Stokel. In center, Hunter Strickland. And in right field, Daylin Denny. Leading things off for Lubbock Christian, the freshman of the year, Savannah Wysocki. In from the left side, we are so happy to have you with us as the first pitch drops in for strike number one. Wysocki in her 51st game, 50th start for the freshman. 30 runs driven in, does have a home run, 13 doubles, and 8 triples, has had herself a nice tournament with 5 base hits as the pitch runs outside for the leadoff hitter. Hitting 294 here in this Heartland Conference tournament. Again, Lubbock Christian, they've had to work through a couple of elimination games, including last night against Texas A&M International, as the conference brief between the starting catcher Out front, Sierra Schultz and Callie Crandall, a couple of young players out there for this Eagles group. They are trying to become the first team for Oklahoma Christian to qualify for the Division II tournament. As that pitch just misses a little bit. Two balls and a strike. Top of the first inning here of this Heartland Conference Championship Series Game 1. If OC wins, they will win the tournament. If Lubbock Christian wins, we'll play another game directly after this. 2-1 delivery is swung on and missed. Strike 2. Wysocki, 64 base hits on the year, chasing the leader, her teammate Lindsey Clemmer, who has 68 of them for this Lubbock Christian group. They're in the white jerseys, the pinstripes here today. Oklahoma Christian, the Maroons. 2-2 delivery is outside, and the count is full at 3-2. You keep an eye on people's arms. You know, Oklahoma Christian's only had to play 2 games in this tournament. Lubbock Christian played 2 on Thursday, played a couple more yesterday, and now they're 5th of the tournament here today. 3-2 delivery is lined back up the middle. That's a base hit. Savannah Wysocki with her 6th hit of the tournament, and she'll be aboard as a leadoff player for Lubbock Christian, a team that's averaged a lot of runs all season, over 7 of them coming into this weekend. Lubbock Christian 32-18, not ranked in the region rankings. Their hope of making the NCAA tournament lies by finding a way to win this tournament. Oklahoma Christian ranked 10th. Again, for them, also trying to do it the easy way for the automatic berth with the winner of this tournament. Now it's Megan Darling, the senior, hitting 373 in her 41st start this season. First pitch is on the outside corner from the freshman, Callie Crandall. 0-1 the count. Top of the first inning, a leadoff base hit aboard at first. It's Savannah Wysocki, who has swiped 13 bases, 2 of them here in the Heartland Conference Tournament. Crandall ready. The 0-1 delivery is upstairs. Wysocki going. Throw down to second is not in time. As Wysocki, no, she is. As hold on, as let's wait and see. As they called safe, and they're calling her out for leaving early is what happened. So Wysocki is going to be called out at second base as Darren Hayes, the head coach in his now 8th season, talking over there with what was seen. The umpires today, Brad Everhart is behind home plate, and Ed Bergman is at first base who made that call. Gwendolyn Bordeaux is out at third base here for this game. Big call here early, so leaving early is the freshman Wysocki. One out, count sits 0-1, and can try to get that figured out on the count. Right now at home plate, there would have been a couple of crazy plays in this tournament. That has been interesting to see, and a bit confusing is now they're going over the count and waiting to see exactly where it's at. It was 0-1. As that pitch was thrown, it would be even, I think. Let's see.
It's a 0-1 count.
So it is no balls and a 1-1 here with one out as Callie Crandall back in the circle ready. Her 33rd appearance on the year for the freshman, an earned run average of 2.71. It has been impressive to watch her not only this tournament but throughout the season. First team all-conference pitcher. She has won 15 times, lost 5. She has struck out 158, 67 walks on the season. 8 complete games as this ball is lifted in the air down towards the left field side. That'll get in foul ground. Strike 2 as it becomes. 1-2. You know, you keep an eye on freshness of arms. You know, you can throw a lot, you know, a little bit easier. Somewhat interesting to see with Oklahoma Christian's Callie Crandall. She has thrown 177 pitches in this tournament coming into today. Had to throw a lot, over 100 in the victory. A 2-hit shutout over Rogers back on Thursday. As that pitch runs high, count even, 2-2. Savannah Wysocki led off the game with a single, but was called out, leaving early, trying to steal second base. The hitter right now at number 2, and Megan, as that pitch is fouled up and out of play by Megan Darling. Counts days 2-2. Darling on the tournament, a couple of hits. She has walked three times, also been used as a sacrifice. Did move some things around at the top of the order. Did Coach Darren Hayes. Lindsey Clemmer has typically been right here, but he moved her down to the three hole for this championship series. As that pitch runs away, count is full at three balls and two strikes. Olivia Villarreal is the cleanup hitter. KK Lopez Liu will bat fifth. Kaylee Arredondo, Morgan DeFour, Logan Grotto, and Alexa Riggs. The remainder of the lineup here for Lubbock Christian. The 3-2 delivery is hit on the ground to first. Into the glove of Upton. She'll step on first base. Two outs here in the top of inning number one. That'll bring up Lindsey Clemmer, the starting second baseman. Clemmer has had a nice tournament. Six base hits and 12 at-bats, a run batted in. A couple of doubles, a couple of walks. Been a real valuable asset for head coach Darren Hayes, who has won this tournament a couple of times. Again, not a ton of years yet for this thing. This ball is rolled to third. Strecker's got it on to first, and that will end the threat. It becomes a 1-2-3 inning. Middle of one, no score. We'll get to the batting lineup and defensive alignment for the teams on the other side. This is the 2019 Heartland Conference Championship Series from San Antonio, Texas.
When I met you in the summer,
sitting here from San Antonio in this championship series of the Heartland Conference 2019 softball championships. Andrew Stassmeister here today. Eagles, if they win, they are the champs. If Lubbock Christian wins, we'll play two games here this afternoon. The starting pitcher for Lubbock Christian is the sophomore Amber Carlton. The right-hander with an earned run average of 4.15 is 8-5 on the year. This will be her 12th start of the season. Carlton, in a couple of starts, is 1-1 at this tournament. Does have a save as well. 16 and a third innings, 8 strikeouts, 3 walks, just a couple of earned runs that she has given up. Been pretty darn good. And you look at both these two teams, I think the main consistent thing between the two of them is their pitching has been very good and allowed them to get to this point offensively. They've made enough happen as the first batter up is Bree Dunkel, and she looks at strike number one. Dunkel, 4 of 7 in this tournament, one of 4 players for Oklahoma Christian in both games to have a hit that they have played. The Eagles have only played 2 games prior to today. This is the 5th of the tournament for Lubbock Christian. As that pitch sits outside, count even at 1-1. The starting pitcher for Oklahoma Christian, Amber Carlton. Her catcher, Megan Darling, behind home plate. Olivia Villarreal is at first. Lindsey Clemmer at second. In the hole, it's short. Alexa Riggs. As the 1-1 delivery is fouled off, a ball and 2 strikes. The third baseman is Morgan DeFore, the senior, in left field. Logan Grotto, center field. Savannah Wysocki, in right field. Kaylee Arredondo. Bottom of the first inning, there is no score. There was a base hit for Lubbock Christian, the freshman of the year in the Heartland Conference, able to reach base. The 1-2 pitch misses just a little bit of Brad Eberhardt's strike zone. The crew chief here today. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Talked about Wysocki reaching, was called out for leaving early. Lubbock Christian ended up going in order on a pair of groundouts to either corner. Sun shining here in San Antonio as the 2-2 pitch is lifted foul down the left field side to get into the Oklahoma Christian dugout. Not a lot of sun the last couple of days here at the park at St. Mary's. It's kind of one of those deals that, you know, rain is forecasted throughout the area, and there was a lot of it that came down last night. In fact, you know, Mother Nature played nice and waited till the games were most of the way done. Only had one rain delay of about 4 minutes yesterday. It was very brief in one of the games that have happened. This is, as it's worth, the number two seed Eagles and the four seeded Lady Chaps of Lubbock Christian here playing. Lubbock in this tournament, they've won three times as that pitch stays down and away. Counter run full, three balls and two strikes. Lubbock Christian knocked out Texas A&M International last night. Had to go nine innings. We've had a lot of close games here throughout as this delivery is swung on and fouled off, and Bree Dunkel getting a chance to see quite a little bit here at the very beginning against Amber Carlton. Dunkel, six base hits against Lubbock Christian this season. Does have an RBI as well. Has also walked a couple of times. Six games so far. 3-2 deliveries, line to third, to four, knocks it down, throws on to first in time. And a good play by the senior third baseman for the first out here in the bottom half of inning number one. Now it'll be Hunter Strickland, who has mixed and matched throughout the top of the order. One of four players that have started every game in this part of the lineup for first-year head coach Shannon Hayes. Strickland hitting .357 on the year. A couple of RBIs, does have five doubles. Finds a way to get on base 42% of the time. Very talented player doing so. As the infield comes in, ball rolled sharply to second. Clemmer's got it and then doesn't. And she will not have a play on it. She will be aboard with one out. Clemmer was coming, but kind of stumbled a little bit. Strickland with pretty good speed. We'll see if it's ruled as a hit. It is as of right now. And we'll check on that to see as that'll pass it along to Kaylee Upton. Or Bridget White, excuse me. Bridget White, the starting shortstop. The senior hitting .289 now on the season. As Lubbock Christian commits the air, Strickland aboard. She can move. Pretty good base stealer. 18 times this year. As the first pitch misses to White, ball one. Bridget White, 1-for-6 in this tournament. Does have a triple. Four base hits this season against Lubbock Christian. White at the top of the order has been a real talented player throughout. As she swings and grounds it in the hole to Riggs, on to second for one. Back to first is not in time. Nice job by Riggs keeping the glove down. She's made some nice plays, but also leads the tournament with five errors. Able to come up with that play. Fielder's choice for Bridget White, who was aboard at first. Hunter Strickland is cut down at second. Two outs. And now Kaylee Upton, the cleanup hitter, will approach. Upton, the senior, hitting .329, her 52nd consecutive starts on the year, has 53 base hits, 44 RBI, lead the team, six home runs, the same category as well. She'll hit from the left side as the first delivery is on the outside corner from Amber Carlton. Again, not many secrets between these two teams in the six times they have faced one another. Oklahoma Christian has won four of those. Shannon Hayes and Darren Hayes just broke their recent tie in seven career meetings as that breaking ball misses just a little bit. Count is even at 1-1. Shannon has won four times. Darren has won three. I'll tell you, you know, talking to both coaches before this game, Shannon was the guy that seemed a lot more nervous, you know, in this big moment, his first ever championship series in the Heartland. 1-1 delivery is hit well in the air to center. Waisaki sees it on the warning track, reaches up over her left shoulder, and will make the grab. That'll end the first inning. One left aboard for the Eagles of Oklahoma Christian. We head to the second. No score between Lubbock Christian and Oklahoma Christian in the 2019 Heartland Conference Softball Championship Series from San Antonio, Texas.
Time to
Start of inning number two here in this Heartland Conference Championship Series. There is no score between Oklahoma Christian, the designated home team, and Lubbock Christian. Andrew Stossmeister back here at the park at St. Mary's. We're glad to have you with us here for today's tournament event finale. Leading things off for Lubbock Christian will be Olivia Villarreal, the junior hitting 349 in 50 starts now this season. Has 51 base hits, 43 runs batted in. Six home runs, has one of those here in this Heartland Conference tournament as she looks at strike one from the freshman, Callie Crandall. Crandall this season, and now her fifth appearance against Lubbock Christian. Four starts, she has gone 3-1 this year for Oklahoma Christian as that pitch is popped up. Shallow left field, runners coming in, and the ball hits the ground. Stokel thought she had it. The wind was completely straight down. White was there, but heard somebody calling her off, and that'll get down. And Lubbock Christian will have another base runner. Well, Stokel, I think, saw it and thought she could get to it. She had a long run. She was playing very deep. White looks like she had a beat on it, but it'll become a base runner at first. Credit is the second hit for Lubbock Christian as Olivia Villarreal will be aboard and replaced by a pinch runner for Lubbock Christian. Christina Sines will get out there and run as everybody going over the lineup card. Base runner at first here in the second inning. Again, one of those deals where the wind has been blowing throughout this tournament at times, but at times just straight down. Stokel had a real difficult play and allows a base runner. We'll see how that affects the contest going forward. KK Lopez Liu now will bat. Liu 3-for-11 here in this tournament. First pitch, look out, is up and in. Might have caught the back of the helmet as she is hit by a pitch for the sixth time this season. And it's first and second. Callie Crandall, 16 hit by pitches this year. And Lubbock Christian has their first scoring chance of this game. Top of the second inning, there is no score. Championship Series, Lubbock has to win twice to claim the championship. Oklahoma Christian needs one win. Crandall, the freshman, has handled the adversity of this tournament in her first year pretty well. Pitched well on Thursday. As that pitch runs outside, ball one. Kaylee Arredondo. Arredondo in this tournament, 4-of-13, has a triple. Runners in first and second, signs the lead runner. That pitch is down and in. Couple outside the zone for Callie Crandall. We talk about, again, Rogers State when she threw on Thursday. Pitched pretty well. Had success and has been very good throughout the season, but had a hard time finding the strike zone throughout a lot of the game that was pretty tight. As that pitch misses inside, it's 3-0. Morgan DeFore is on deck for the Lady Chaps, residing in the first base dugout here today. Fans, good amount of them out watching here on a sunny day. First game that has started with sun here this weekend as that pitch is called a strike at the knees on the inside part of the plate. 3-1, the count. Top of inning number two, there is no score. A couple of base hits for Lubbock Christian. Inning started off with a little bit of a miscommunication on a base hit into shallow left field. Hit by pitch behind that. Nobody out. Corner infielders are in, and that's going to catch the inside part of Kaylee Arredondo. And the bases are loaded for Morgan DeFore. Morgan 0-for-3 in this tournament with the bases full. Lubbock Christian has done this plenty of times already. And, you know, you look at that, it's a big moment as Shannon Hayes, you know, who I talked to, again, a little bit nervous before this game, which doesn't happen for a guy that has won as many games as he has. 406, former head coach at Texas Tech, who won 30 or more in five straight seasons. You know, came into a situation that, you know, he said he wasn't too worried about, but it's a challenging situation to replace a, you know, longtime coach like Tom Heath was here for. Take over, and obviously the cabinet not bare. He's done a good job having the seniors buy into everything that he has brought with him. Darren and Shannon, longtime brothers, of course, and getting a chance to face off against one another. You know, talk to Darren. Darren was fine. You know, he wasn't too nervous about this moment. He said, you know, hey, I'm excited to be here. You know, he's won this tournament a couple of times. Not a lot of pressure, but there's a great competitiveness between the two of them. Of course, their dad, Larry, setting all of that up beforehand. Larry took over at Colorado Christian. Not sure. They weren't sure if he was going to make it here. His team went out yesterday from Grand Junction. He said he might try to catch a flight, but don't know if he'll make it here or not. Bases are loaded. Morgan DeFour, the hitter. First pitch from Callie Crandall is outside, ball one. Crandall, I thought, in that first game, again, same umpire, same zone, Brad Eberhardt, you know, had some issues against Rogers State. Rogers wasn't able to come up with a number of chances. A lot of people left on base in that game on Thursday. As that pitch drops in for strike one, count is even. 51 career home runs for the right-handed hitting senior, Morgan DeFour. Second most ever in the Heartland Conference's 20-year history. The 1-1 pitch, fouled off, count runs a ball and two strikes. Lubbock Christian has won this tournament twice, 2016 and 2017. They did not make the championship series last year. Oklahoma Christian has been here the last 2 years. They have not won it. Trying to accomplish a lot of firsts and make their first NCAA tournament. Most believe that the team that wins this tournament will be the only team that qualifies from the Heartland Conference. As that pitch is fouled up and out of play on the third base side. There haven't been too many upsets yet, at least across the South Central region. The Texas A&M, Kingsville, Commerce, those two teams are right at the top out of the Lone Star. They're playing semifinals today. Colorado Mesa is the favorite and top seed in the RMAC. And then you have the Heartland that make up that region. As this ball is bounced back up the middle, base hit. One run will score. Here comes the throw. It is online, but out of the glove of Schultz. Sliding in safely from second base will be KK Lopez Liu. And it's 2-0. Lubbock Christian strikes first here in the top of the second inning on a RBI hit of the middle from the senior Morgan DeFour. Well, DeFour did what you wanted right there. Put the ball on the ground and drive it up the middle and collect what was coming to her with the bases loaded. Gets a couple of runs in. That was impressive for her. And now it's once again runners at second and third for Logan Grondle, the left fielder. Grondle getting a chance to start here has been substituted throughout this tournament. There is nobody out as she looks at strike number one. And a couple of base runners still out there. Arredondo at third. DeFour moved up on that throw. She is at second. Two runs are in for Lubbock Christian. They've got to win twice. And again, their region ranking not in the top 10 before this tournament as that pitch is lifted foul into the second level here at the park at St. Mary's on the third base side. Count runs, two strikes on Grotto. 0-2 officially. He's also been hit by a pitch and walked. Again, has been used more in the pinch. This, I do believe, her first start of the tournament. Her seventh on the year. Crandall ready. The 0-2 delivery is swung on and fouled off. Got the home plate umpire and the catcher, I think. Crandall trying to take deep breaths. Again, 3-1 this year against Lubbock Christian. Came in with 17 strikeouts, still with that same number. Has given up 8 earned runs, but 6 of them came in the loss. The 0-2 delivery is outside. Ball runs 1-2. Arredondo at third, Morgan DeFour at second with a single and 2 RBIs driven in already. Olivia Villarreal with that single to start this thing off on a miscommunication in left field between the shortstop White and Stokel, the left fielder. As that pitch is waved at and missed, Grotto goes down on strikes for the first out of the inning. Now it'll be Alexa Riggs batting, the freshman in her 49th start of the year. We'll bat right here. No, it's actually going to be Schwarzenberg. Annika Schwarzenberg, who will have the chance to pinch hit. Schwarzenberg 0-2 in this tournament. Both at bats by way of the pinch. The junior getting an opportunity right here to hit. See how she handles it. Schwarzenberg 1-6 this season against Oklahoma Christian. Average at 303. for the backup infielder. Schwarzenberg with 24 runs batted in. Does have a couple of home runs. Two in scoring position. First pitch swung on and missed. Swung underneath that one, strike one. Top of the second, two runs are in. Three in total for Lubbock Christian in the game. Two in this inning. They've also committed an error that has not cost them. That was in the last half. The 0-1 delivery misses outside, count even at one ball and one strike. These two teams did play yesterday, and it was a very good, very close competitive game. A lot of fun to watch it. End up being won by the Eagles of Oklahoma Christian, walk-off fashion in the bottom of the seventh inning. Crandall came on in relief as that pitch is fouled up and out of play. Count sits at a ball and two strikes. Eberhardt was the home plate umpire for that game as well. Lubbock had seven hits. Oklahoma Christian had eight. Still early here in this championship series from San Antonio. Top of the second, but Lubbock Christian looking for a crooked spot. The 1-2 delivery is popped up. That'll get up and out of play over the backstop. Count remains at 1-2. Crandall having to really work here early on. Crandall in her 19th start of the year. She has finished eight games. The 1-2. Popped up. Schwarzenberg just got a piece of that one. See if she can see something a little bit different. Now, Crandall's got six pitches that she has worked throughout this tournament. A lot to choose from for the freshman out of Artesia, New Mexico, the 2018 Player of the Year at the high school level there last year. The 1-2 delivery. That's upstairs and the count will even. Lubbock Christian with a two spot here in this inning. Trying to win its third ever Heartland Conference Championship in the conference's final season. 2-2 pitch. That rolls in, ball three. First base is open, by the way. Savannah Wysocki is on deck. She singled back in the first. Three balls and two strikes. Arredondo at third, DeFore at second. The payoff pitch swung on and hit a long way to left. It's foul territory, and Stokel's not going to make the grab. Stokel was running to it. Looked like she had a beat on it, but then kind of slowed up a little bit because if she catches that, a chance to tag up at third for Arredondo and likely score. Wonder if that's what the mentality was. There's one out. It was going to take a great effort to make the play, but if she makes it, probably a run still scores. Trying to put it back in Crandall's hands again as the 3-2 pitch is swung on and fouled off. Good battle going on right now. Count is full at three balls and two strikes. One out, top of the second. Runners at second and third. Crandall looking in at Schultz, a young battery, freshman and sophomore. The 11th pitch of the sequence. Yeah. On the inside corner, strike three called. Oh, man, that was a close pitch. And Coach Darren Hayes not pleased on the second strikeout of the inning. Schwarzenberg retired back to the top of the order. Now looking for a two-out RBI. Fans not real happy either for Lubbock Christian. You could hear him behind home plate. Clean slate now for Savannah Wysocki. One for one here today. 6-for-18 at this tournament. As she swings and pops it up, that'll get out and into the seats on the third base side. One strike. Wysocki has had a lot of success this year against Oklahoma Christian. 11-for-19, couple of RBI. The freshman with 65 base hits, average above 330 right now. Crandall the sign from the dugout, the 0-1 delivery. That stays outside. Cattle even up at 1-1. Wysocki, the seventh player to bat here in the inning. Top of 2-0, Lady Chaps. Crandall, you can tell, trying to suppress emotions as the 1-1 pitch is popped up. That is also going to get into the seats and head towards some of the fans that are sitting out there. Tell you what, everybody's been bringing the umbrellas for the rain the last couple of days. Today they might use them for more of the shade as some are doing so far at the park. good day for a championship series. Mid-70s in San Antonio. There are clouds around the area, but knock on wood, no rain in the forecast until much later on this evening. The 1-2 delivery is outside. Count goes 2 balls and 2 strikes. Wysocki, named the Freshman of the Year in the Heartland Conference, has led the team all year in triples, tied for first in the NCAA right now. 19, make it 20 multi-hit games as she swings and drives it to center, ranging to her right as Hunter Strickland, the senior. She makes the grab, and that will end the threat. Two left to board, but Lubbock Christian scores twice, and they take the lead 2-0 in the middle of the second inning between Lubbock Christian and Oklahoma Christian. This is the 2019 Heartland Conference Softball Championship Series from San Antonio, Texas. At St. Mary's in San Antonio, Texas. St. Mary's, the host of this 2019 and final Heartland Conference Championship Tournament. Andrew Stossmeister back for the championship Saturday. Again, Lubbock Christian has to win 2. Oklahoma Christian has to win 1. Somebody walks out of here with the automatic berth to the NCAA Tournament, something that Oklahoma Christian has never accomplished. Leading things off, the left fielder Lindsey Stokel batting from the right side against Amber Carlton. First pitch is on the inside part of the plate for strike one. These two teams have played 6 times this year. Oklahoma Christian has won 4 of those, including yesterday's 2-1 victory. The 0-1 delivery stays down and low slightly. And a beautiful day for softball. We talk about how much nicer it is to see some good weather that is here. 76 degrees when we got started right at 12 o'clock. We're in the bottom of the second, 2-0 Lady Chaps. That pitch is swung on and it's a long way, but it is foul. Count runs the ball and 2 strikes. Stokel on the year hitting 326. The sophomore in her 52nd consecutive start. Stokel, the former cowgirl at Oklahoma State, has that pitch in just a little bit. And I'll tell you, one of the things, you know, talking with Coach Shannon Hayes about why he left Denver, one of the draws certainly to being right there in the heart of softball country in Oklahoma City. A lot of good players, and you might find a couple of these type of transfers as that pitch is swung on and fouled towards the dugout where the Eagles are at here today. Been in there the entirety of this tournament, the previous 2 games and now 3rd that they've played. This is their 3rd game. It's Lubbock Christian's 5th. Lubbock Christian with a win on day 1 against Texas A&M International. Also beat St. Mary's in extra innings. Close games throughout. As that pitch runs away. You know, the tournament has yielded a lot of real good contests. Of 7 games played, 6 of them have been decided by 1 run. The only game that was not was a 6-0 victory for Oklahoma Christian, a 2-hit shutout tossed by Callie Crandall. As that pitch inside, and I think it catches the hip of Lindsey Stokel. She's aboard to lead off this second inning. So Stokel, hit for the 13th time, will be aboard. And that's not one of those things you see a whole lot. Talk about someone that, you know, hey, however you can get on base, she's right up there in the top couple of this Heartland Conference. Now it's Kayla Eichler, the designated player. That will bat right here. Eichler hitting 362. This is her 48th start of the year. 30 runs driven in. Does have a home run. 10 doubles, 3 triples on the year. She looks at strike one from Amber Carlton. Thought there might be a base runner. Lubbock Christian trying to find a way to win this tournament once again. One of the top offensive teams, had a new pitching staff largely coming into this season. They have done enough to keep them close and leaned heavily on their offense most of the year. As the runner is going, throw down a second. Look out, into center field goes that throw. Stolen base accomplished successfully by Lindsey Stokel. Oklahoma Christian led the league in stolen bases this season. Stokel now 10 for 11. On the year, into scoring position. 2-0 Lubbock Christian. They played their first two of the game in the top half of this inning. OC trying to answer. Eagles 37 and 14. Lubbock Christian 32 and 18. Carlton, the sophomore, taking a breath, is ready. She fires. That pitch is on the corner at the knee. Strike two. Good location. That was down right there. Again, I think both teams familiar with the strike zone. You know, throughout this tournament, there haven't been a lot of big ones. They've been pretty tight. And, you know, Everhart has been very consistent with his. Certainly got to earn your spots before you start getting maybe a little bit more, as that pitch is swung on and missed. Strike three on the first strikeout of the day by Carlton, her 61st of the season. That'll be Sierra Schultz, who comes up with one out and a runner at second. Schultz won the game yesterday in the bottom of the seventh inning on a base hit through the left side. Came in a pinch. She has had herself a nice tournament. A player that has earned the start here today. Injuries throughout the year. From right out here of the San Antonio area. She swings and fouls that off. One strike. Schultz. 1-for-4. Including the game-winning hit yesterday. Came on and pinch hit relief. Middle of the game. Stayed in the game. And was able to contribute. He's got 4 hits this year against Lubbock Christian. As the off-speed pitch is nubbed slowly to second. Clemmer fields and tosses it on to first. 2 outs. Moving to third base goes Lindsey Stokel, 60 feet away to try to play Oklahoma Christian's first run. Schultz didn't really notice. I think she hit it. Didn't get out of the box particularly quick. And ended up being a little bit surprised as she tried to hustle down the line. Now it's Daylin Denny, who will be left up looking for a 2-out RBI. A couple of these in the tournament so far for Oklahoma Christian. Denny on the season, the average right at 300 for the sophomore. This is her 50th game on the year. 22 runs driven in, 3 home runs. And used in a variety of ways as she swings and drives it right at Logan Grotto and left, who almost took a step backwards but makes the grab for the third out. A runner left at third for Oklahoma Christian as we head to the third inning. 2-0, Lubbock Christian leading this championship series from San Antonio, Texas, in the 2019 Heartland Conference softball tournament. Inning number 3 here from San Antonio, the 2019 Heartland Conference Championship Series here on day number 3 of this double elimination tournament. 5 teams started. The number 1 team, St. Mary's, did not win a game. The number 3 team that possessed the conference pitcher of the year eliminated. Texas A&M International got a pretty good deep run of their own, winning multiple times, nearly able to come all the way back and beat Lubbock Christian. Took him to 9 innings last night for the right to play in this series. Got a 3-run homer in the 7th to help out, but they couldn't come all the way back. Lubbock Christian eventually played it a run to win the game and move to this series. As this ball is slapped deep in the hole to short, White fields on to first, not in time. And it's a leadoff single from Megan Darling. Darling with her first hit of the day. And for Darling, that is her third hit of the tournament. Didn't hit it real hard over there, but a deep spot out there that was a challenge for White to get to. She has shown a great arm and great range at the shortstop position throughout this tournament. Pretty good throw, but pretty good wheels out there for Darling. Clemmer will hit. Will she bunt? She does not. First pitch is in there for a strike. Might have been part of the reason for the move down. Again, Clemmer's got great ability. Again, leading the team in average right at 400. 68 base hits on the year, but has power to go along with it as well. The 0-1 delivery. Called a strike on the outside part of the plate. Strike two. Nobody out, runner at first. We're in the top of the third. 2-0. Lady Chaps in front. They have to win twice. Callie Crandall looking to the dugout for the sign where Shannon Hayes gives it to her, and now timeout is called. Clemmer a bit miffed on that last call. First time he's seen a little bit more of an extension of that strike zone. The 0-2. That one's a little further out. Count runs, a ball, and two strikes. And, you know, you see this, I think, as the game goes on. And I think pretty fair. You see an umpire maybe start with a zone that's, you know, really the plate. And then as pitchers hit their spots, might earn a little bit more on either side. The 1-2 delivery is hit a long way, but foul down the left field side. Get up and off the netting and out of play. 1-2 the count. Clemmer a ground out. Her first time up to third. The 1-2 delivery, runner not moving. Count will even at 2-2. Lindsey Clemmer hitting just under 240 against Oklahoma Christian this year. 5-22 on the season. Does have 4 runs driven in. Also walked 3 times against the Eagles in 6 games. The 2-2. That's outside. The count runs full. Olivia Villarreal is on deck, who singled to start things off in that second inning. Eventually came around to score. Part of the order with a lot of hits for Lubbock Christian. The 3-2. Swung on and hit foul. Good at bat going right here. Got a chance to catch up and talk with Coach Darren Hayes while he was warming everybody up. He said, first, my arm doesn't fall off. This could be a good day, but he liked the approach. You know, everybody stayed pretty calm and collected with his players. They were pretty pleased getting to this game, but they're not here just to be here. As that pitch bounces in, and that did not catch, but it's ball 4. Moving on to second goes Darling. So first and second, nobody out. Once again for Lubbock Christian. They have left people on base, averaging over 7 per game on the season. Mount that here throughout this tournament as Clemmer reaches. Now it's Olivia Villarreal who will hit. 52 hits on the year, 43 runs driven in, trying to bunt, unsuccessful on that first attempt, 1 strike. Lubbock Christian with just 13 sacrifices all year. They did pick up a sack fly in this tournament. And not a team that bunts very often. I'd imagine this is not something for Villarreal that she does a whole lot. She does have 2 successful sacrifice bunts. The 0-1 is bunted. That is foul. Strike 2. You know, we talked about this, I thought, a lot Thursday and Friday. You know, in clutch situations when the Lady Chaps needed to bunt, they were able to do it. For a team that, you know, was at the bottom of the league in sacrifices throughout this season. Now let's see if it changes for the newcomer of the year in the Heartland Conference. First and second, nobody out. 0-2 delivery is swung on and fouled off as Villarreal pulled the bat back and tried to swing. Outfield playing deep. Corners have gone back a little bit more to regular depth. Wonder if Coach Hayes would see if His first baseman could bunt right back to the circle and try to move the runners with the corner infielders back a little bit more as that pitch is outside. One ball and two strikes. Fun to watch the chess match yesterday between Shannon and Darren. It's no different here today. Both guys have made some adjustments on the pregame lineup cards. They've tried to take their spots here early. The 1-2, strike three. First out recorded here in this third inning. 2-0 in favor of Lubbock Christian. And now it'll be K.K. Lopez-Liu, who was hit back in the second. Both her and Arredondo in that 5-6 hole both reached. Lopez-Liu came around to score the second run of the game. As the first pitch is on the outside part of the plate for a called strike one. There is one out. Lubbock Christian has threatened in each inning. Although Wysocki, who reached, looked like she had stolen second base, was called out for leaving early. Next two outs recorded in order before seven players batted in the second. Two runs scored. Two were also left aboard as the senior Morgan DeFore drove in two runs with nobody out. 0-2 the count here on K.K. Lopez-Liu with two runners on. The delivery stays high. A ball and two strikes with one out. Darling at second. She can move. Clemmer behind her, also a threat to run. Probably two of the faster players for the Lady Chaps. As that pitch is popped up, but it's in between Dunkel, who makes the grab and throws it on to first. That serves as a productive out for Lubbock Christian. That'll move the runners. It wasn't quite high enough to get the ruling for infield fly and not allow people to move over, but it does mean the results of the second out of the inning. And now Kaylee Arredondo looking for a two-out knock. Runners at second and third as they both moved up. Darling the lead runner. Clemmer behind her. Strike one on Arredondo. No official at bats. Got hit by a pitcher last time up. Was stranded at third base. Callie Crandall trying to beat Lubbock Christian for the fourth time this year. The pitch swung on and lined foul. Bailey Strecker at third was playing in, but wasn't as close to the line as she had been playing earlier. You know, we've seen teams throughout this tournament, you really keep people as close as you can, that if something is, you know, reactionary right at you, that you can protect yourself and not let it get by you for extra bases. But she was playing off a little bit, and Coach Hayes said, hey, a little closer to the line. The 0-2 delivery, fastball stays high to Arredondo from the freshman Callie Crandall, all-conference player who won 15 games this year. Okay. 154 innings now as the 1-2 call, strike three. Fourth of the game for the freshman on her 162nd of the season. Two left aboard for Lubbock Christian. Middle of three. Lady Chaps in front 2-0 of this championship series of the 2019 Heartland Conference Tournament from San Antonio, Texas.
Thank you.
bottom of the third inning from the park at St. Mary's. We're in San Antonio, Texas for this championship series between Lubbock Christian and Oklahoma Christian. Andrew Stassmeister back. We're glad to have you with us here for this tournament. Today's game is presented by Star Shuttle and Charter, the exclusive transportation provider of St. Mary's Athletics. Star Shuttle and Charter, they go the distance for you. Leading things off here for Oklahoma Christian, it'll be Bailey Strecker at the bottom of the order. She swings and pops it up and out of play. One strike, only player to not hit for Oklahoma Christian yet. The junior hitting 245 in her 51st start of the year. 35 base hits, 29 runs driven in, does have three home runs. She swings at that one and lines it just foul past Villarreal, who was over there at first base, in front of Coach Shaylee Cordell. Trying to keep things in front as home plate umpire Brad Eberhart's on to check the softball and make sure it's all right. Well, yesterday, especially in the middle two games, you watched softballs going in left and right almost every other pitch, it seemed like. There's some water on the field. It was wet, and made it a little bit difficult to grip at times. This pitch is fouled off by Strecker. Strecker, 1-for-4 in this tournament so far. Does have a couple of runs driven in. Has also been a sacrifice bunt player in this tournament so far. 0-2 delivery is high. Good eye up there by the junior. A player that's been playing a long time now for Oklahoma Christian. First for Coach Tom Heath, the longtime head coach, and then Shannon Hayes. Strecker, the former player at St. Louis University, rips that one foul. And a talented player. Second team Heartland Conference a year ago. Count sits 1-2. Bottom of the third inning, 2-0 Lubbock Christian. They've got 4 hits and an error. No official hits yet today for Oklahoma Christian. But they have had some base runners, 3 of them to be exact. The 1-2 delivery off speed stays outside as Darling will chuck it back. She's been a nice catcher throughout this tournament as well for Lubbock Christian, playing their 5th game. It's just the 3rd for the second-seeded Eagles. The 2-2. Hit well in the air to center. Wysocki going back, but having room with that left foot forward, reaches up shoulder high and makes the grab. The first out of the inning. Third fly out of the game for Oklahoma Christian. Trying to find a place to put the softball. You know, their victories, when they've scattered hits, they've kept the ball a large part on the ground. Back to the top of the order with Bree Dunkel, starting at 2nd here today. Dunkel, 6-for-14 against Oklahoma Christian this season. Does have an RBI. It's also walked a couple of times. Left-hander hitting 366. The pitch swung on and lifted in the air to right. Arredondo will not try to throw out a base runner. And there is the first base hit of the game for Oklahoma Christian. Goes out to right field with 1 out. And now Hunter Strickland up. That'll allow first-year head coach Shannon Hayes to be creative. See how the Lady Chaps will play it. Darren Hayes sitting up on a chair in the corner of the dugout. See how far he brings his corner infielders in. And just like that, you watch 60 feet almost get cut in half from Morgan DeFore, who is at third base. The hitter, Hunter Strickland, reached on an error her first time up towards second base. Not bunting as the first pitch, strike 1. That one right there in the bottom half of the zone. Strickland, 6-for-19 against Oklahoma Christian this year. Does have a couple of extra base hits. Also walked a pair of times. The 0-1 delivery outside. Good pick out there by Darling in the dirt. You know, she's keeping an eye out there on Bree Dunkel. 22 stolen bases. She can move out there. Top of the league with those swipes. Carlton, the 1-1, runner not going. 2-1 just outside. You can tell. Again, Dunkel's waiting for her pitch. You can tell Coach Hayes at third also waiting to see when's he going to get a breaking ball. Is he going to get something soft? You know, Carlton has stayed with all power right now. 2-1. There's one out bottom of the third inning in a two-run game. Oklahoma Christian's first hit at first base right now. The 2-1, runner's going back up the middle. Riggs gloves it onto first in time on a close play. Nice job over there by Riggs. Again, handling one that crawled all the way up her shoulder. She makes the grab. It. A good throw to first, able to record it now. It would serve as the good out for Oklahoma Christian as they move the runner over. And now it passes it over to Bridget White. Moving to second is Dunkel in scoring position. Two outs now. As White, who hit into the fielder's choice her last time up, being patient, waits as the first pitch is outside, ball one. White, with four base hits against Oklahoma Christian in six-plus games this year, does not have any RBI. None of those 33 against Lubbock Christian. The 1-0 pitch, soft, Lee hit into the air and left. Is it down? It is. It's going to get in front of Grotto. Scoring easily is Bree Dunkel, sliding into second. On the play is Bridget White. And she'll trade places as Oklahoma Christian scores their first run here in the bottom of the third inning. Well, White was out in front, stopped the hands as she saw something very soft in front of her and just drilled the ball into left. But Grotto, who was playing back, did not have a play. And then able to move up on the throw with White as Dunkel scores the first run of the game and collects a two-out RBI in the process. Now it's Kaylee Upton, who swings and lifts the ball in the air to left. Just looking at it is Grotto. A step away from the track will make the grab. But Oklahoma Christian scores their first run of the game by way of a two-out RBI. One left to board as we head to the fourth inning. 2-1, Lubbock Christian leading Oklahoma Christian in this Heartland Conference Softball Championship Series from San Antonio, Texas. Start of the fourth inning here from San Antonio, Texas, the 2019 Heartland Conference Championship Tournament. This is the championship series between Oklahoma Christian and Lubbock Christian. The Eagles get their first run of the game. They trail 2-1. Lubbock has to win twice. Oklahoma Christian seeking their first ever Heartland Conference Championship. They need to win once as Morgan DeFore swings and misses at the first pitch on a breaking ball, 0-1. DeFore first time up, a single back up the middle, drove in the two runs for Lubbock. The 0-1 delivery, did she hold up? They'll peel down to first. They say she did. Count is even at 1-1. DeFore, quite the year she has had, and really the career for that matter here in the Heartland Conference. Started her play at St. Edward's in Austin. Spent a couple of years there. One-time freshman of the year. Been at all conference, everywhere, every spot she's been at here in these two stops. She's ahead in the count, 2-1 right now. 51 home runs as we talk about it. She swings, and that's why. You put a swing like that together, you keep it in the post, it easily goes. We saw some big shots yesterday. teams have been able to hit some home runs. There haven't been many of them, but, you know, Madison Schofield for International. A couple big shots in the game that extended the game last night with Lubbock to 9 innings. This pitch is popped up. That'll get into the seats on the third base side once again. Got a go-ahead home run for International, who beat St. Mary's yesterday to eliminate them from the tournament. Did that in the top of the eighth inning. St. Mary's lost both of their games as the top seed, both of them in extras, both of them one-run games. Lubbock Christian beat them, as did Texas A&M International. Roger State, the first team that bowed out. They lost on day one as that pitch is popped up towards the backstop and fouled off. Count stays 2 balls and 2 strikes. You know, there wasn't a lot of separation between these teams throughout the season. Seeding all very close. The Eagles in a share of the league title with St. Mary's won 19 games. Lubbock Christian finished 16-14 in the league. 2-2 pitch is high and the count is full at 3-2. One walk issued so far by Callie Crandall. She's got 4 strikeouts on the day. Also has hit a couple of batters. The 3-2 swung on and ripped foul. Look out. Holy smokes. Coach Shannon Hayes had pulled the hat off. He said that came right at him. It looks over there and kind of whistles something back. And DeFore going, what's going on? That one nearly got Shannon. Is inches away as it grazed over the shoulder on the right side. 3 balls and 2 strikes. Callie Crandall ready. The right-hander delivers the payoff pitch, and it's high. Ball 4. That's a great at-bat there by the veteran. I'll tell you, we've seen some seniors have some really, really good at-bats in this tournament for all 5 teams. That's a big one right there. Again, you fall behind early, a ball and 2 strikes, and eventually work it back after fouling off a couple of pitches. Now it's Logan Grotto who will hit a strikeout back in inning number 2. Grotto on the season has had her moments with 10 base hits. Again, not really a regular starter this year. Has been more of a substitute. Been used that way this tournament. She's 0 for 3 looking for her first hit. She has walked and gotten hit by a pitch. She turned and showed bunt, but pulled back as the pitch was down and in, 1-0. Nobody out, top of the fourth inning. It is 2-1. Lubbock Christian, 2 runs, 4 hits in an error. Oklahoma Christian had their first hit and first run in the last inning. They have 2 in total. Lubbock Christian, again, is the only team that's committed an error so far. As pitches inside as well, 2-0 the count. Shannon Hayes up there in the corner of the dugout, asking where that pitch was at. It was in. Got a strike zone very consistent from Brad Everhart behind home plate. The 2-0. Down and in again. 3-0. And we start worrying about Morgan DeFore, maybe if she runs. I mean, Morgan's not a player that's going to take a lot of bases. She does have 2 swipes this season. And career-wise, there's not a whole lot out there for her. The 3-0 pitch, that's right over the plates for a strike. Top of this fourth inning of the 2019 Heartland Conference Softball Tournament, game number 8. We're in San Antonio, mid-70s. Sunshine here today. Good change after overcast skies the last few days. 3-1 delivery is hit in the air towards left. Towering fly ball right near the fence as the grab is made by Lindsey Stokel for the out. That's a good job over there by Stokel, having a good feel of the track and running up just shy of the wall to make the grab. One away here in the fourth inning. That initially looked like it was going foul, but it stayed right there hugging the line. As the grab is made, second fly out of the game for Lubbock Christian. They've done a good job keeping the ball down on the ground so far. Now with 1 out and DeFore at first base, it is back to Alexa Riggs, who is out there. Riggs did not hit the first time up. She was substituted for Annika Schwarzenberg. Riggs, the freshman, hitting .315 this year, has 29 base hits. She tries to bunt. It's popped up into the catcher's mitt. Throw back to first is not in time. One out recorded to make two for the inning. Well, Riggs tried to quickly almost slap bunt at it and just didn't do what you're supposed to. Got underneath it and popped it up. Nice play by Schultz, the catcher, who was quickly out of the crouch for the second out. Able to get back to first. Morgan DeFore, two outs. As it flips the card to Savannah Wysocki. One for one today. Runners going. Throw down to second. DeFore is out. Good throw over there by the catcher, Sierra Schultz, who was waiting, you could tell. And she finds a way to toss out the base runner at second. Middle of four, 2-1. Lubbock Christian leading Oklahoma Christian of this championship series of the 2019 Heartland Conference Tournament from San Antonio. Of the fourth inning here from San Antonio, Texas. A nice throw by Sierra Schultz as she cuts down her second base runner of the season and ends the inning for the Lady Chaps. Andrew Stassmeister back, glad to have you with us for this championship series. Today's series is presented by Nike. Shop your style with Nike shoes for running, training, basketball, and more. You can shop Nike.com for the ultimate selection of shoes, clothing, and apparel. Free shipping for members plus free 30-day returns. Nike, just do it. Leading things off for Oklahoma Christian, they will have Lindsey Stokel, who was hit by a pitcher first time up. And by hit by a pitch, I mean might have gotten grazed on the hip. Again, there have been three players that have been hit and really not squared up. Just a couple of pitches for either pitcher trying to work inside. That is a strike call. Count is even at 1-1. Bottom of the fourth, Oklahoma Christian, if they win this game, they're the Heartland Conference champions, and they earn the automatic berth, which would be their first in the NCAA Division II era. Lubbock Christian, they've got to win twice, trying to qualify for the third time as that pitch is slugged through the left side, base hit. And Oklahoma Christian will have the leadoff player on here to begin this fourth inning. Second time they accomplished that feat after Stokel did the same thing in that second inning, but in that case, she actually got hit by the pitch, so she's aboard. And Stokel, once again with some speed, is out there with 10 swipes. Now it passes it along to Kayla Eichler. The designated player struck out her first time up, 0 for 1. Eichler 4 for 18 this season against Lubbock Christian. Does possess a home run as she's swinging. Runner is going. It is a foul ball. One strike on the hitter is fire walking out. Going to give the catcher a moment as Coach Shannon Hayes looking over there at Kayla Eichler. Can just try to talk situationally about where things are at. The Eagles, 7 victories in this conference tournament. They have been in the final the last couple of years. They have not won it. Beaten by Lubbock a few years ago. Can coaching on one end, Darren Hayes was here. Shannon was not. That time, Shannon was down in Lakewood, Colorado. coaching for Colorado Christian. 0-1 bunt try is to first, bobbled slightly by Villarreal. Her throw on to first base is in time. Kayla Eichler with the successful sacrifice. Moving on to second base goes Stokel, who is in scoring position with one out. That's the 45th sacrifice of the year for Oklahoma Christian, second only to St. Mary's, who led the conference. So a runner at second, one out. And Sierra Schultz will be the batter. 0-for-1 today, a ground out to second, her first time up. Schultz 4-for-10, against Lubbock Christian. Does have a home run, couple of runs driven in. This is just her fourth game, though, against. Again, Schultz has been injured as that pitch is in there for a called strike. Schultz missed all of March and the beginning of April with an injury out of Schertz, Texas, which is just up the road from here. Really was playing well, was starting. Trying to get back into her groove as that pitch is outside. Moving up to third and taking the base is Lindsey Stokel, who is safe going to third. Stokel's 11th steal of the year. 0-2 the count, one out. Oklahoma Christian being aggressive, thought that would happen. That is their 100th steal of the year. 0-2 as Schultz now will walk down and talk to Coach Shannon Hayes about the situation, representing the tying run at third. Four hits in the game for Lubbock Christian. Oklahoma Christian has three. These two teams in the South Central region, knowing of their situation, there is a possibility that if Lubbock Christian won twice, Oklahoma Christian could get in potentially to the NCAA tournament, but they've been kind of in that spot the last few years, close and unable to do so. Typically, it's been only the conference champion. Looks like six bids, once again, might go to the Lone Star Conference. Also depends on what happens in the RMAC Conference, the Rocky Mountain Athletic Region. As the 0-2 delivery is outside, 1-2. Colorado Mesa, sixth in the region rankings this week that were released. Teams will find out who's going to the NCAA tournament on Monday. One ball and two strikes. The pitch upstairs. Good job by Darling to stretch out and grab that. That was in the high pocket of the mitt just to stop that. If not, that's to the backstop. And a decision to be made by Lindsey Stokel at third. 2-2. One out here in the bottom of the fourth. One run game. The pitch swung on and ripped. That's fair down the third baseline. A run will tie the game. Digging for second is going to be Sierra Schultz. And she has had the number of the Lady Chaps of Lubbock Christian. And she ties the game here in the bottom of the fourth with the RBI. Her 19th of the season. Now that ball was absolutely smoked. Sierra Schultz continuing to give the opportunity to Oklahoma Christian and the Eagles. Just got a fastball there at the knees and went out and reached for it a little bit, but the hands so quick to the softball to drive it down the line and by Morgan DeFore. That's not an easy thing to do at all. For one of the best at third in this league, as this pitch is hit back up the middle into the glove of Riggs at short. Throw on to first, two outs. Good job by Riggs to stay back and make the play for the second out of the inning. Staying at second was Sierra Schultz. Did not even move away from second. Now it's Bailey Strecker looking for a base hit. Flew out to deep center her last time up. One two-out RBI already for Oklahoma Christian. Another would give this team the lead, their first of the day, as this pitch is hit a long way, but it is foul. That one gets off the top of the practice facility down at the third baseline here at the park at St. Mary's in San Antonio for this 2019 Heartland Conference Tournament. The number one seeded Rattlers upset in both of their games in extra innings. Second team to go out of this tournament. Rogers State, the third seed, eliminated first. 0-1 delivery is upstairs. Count even, 1-1. Two outs, bottom of the fourth. Tie game at two. Each team has four hits. Lubbock Christian has an error. It has not factored into the score. Fifth batter to face Amber Carlton is that pitch. Misses outside, and now they will check and see if there was a swing or not. There is not. 2-1. Strecker looking for her first base hit of the game. She's got 35 on the year. How nice is that to be able to say you have players that have 30 or more hits at the bottom of your order? Both these two teams can say that. 2-1, popped up, foul ground. Catcher giving chase, reaching up over there, but Darling cannot make the grab. She went too far, almost overran it a little bit. Ball came back and caught a lot of her right hand, and not happy that she missed it. Ran to the on-deck circle, had some space over there where Bree Dunkel was at. Just couldn't quite come up with it to end the inning. New chance for Strecker. How does she take it? 2-2. Carlton looking in. The pitch swung on and hit in the air towards right. Long run, reaching in foul ground is Arredondo, who makes the grab, spills to the deck, but still hangs on. As that'll end the inning, one left aboard. Oklahoma Christian ties the game, however, on a double down the left field line from Sierra Schultz. We go to the fifth here of this championship series, all knotted up at two. This is the 2019 Heartland Conference Softball Tournament Championship Series from San Antonio, Texas. Of inning number five here from San Antonio. Tie game between Lubbock Christian and Oklahoma Christian. Andrew Stossmeister back for this championship round. If Oklahoma Christian wins, they will make their first ever NCAA Division II tournament. They only have to win once. If it's going to be Lubbock Christian doing it for the third time, they will have to win twice here today. Game tied at two and a pitching change, as it'll be Madison Haygood who will come on here in relief. Both these two teams almost mirror each other with what they have done with their pitching approach, throwing two people throughout this tournament, and no different right here. For Madison Haygood, 15 wins, 7 losses, an earned run average at 2.32. This is her 37th appearance on the year. Does have a save. Haygood in this tournament started one time. Picked up the victor, did not factor into the decision yesterday. Pitched 4 2/3 in this game, a strikeout, a walk, and an earned run. Did toss 81 pitches, but trying to mix it up here for the left-hander. Crandall at least out right now with 4 innings worth. She was at 87 pitches. She gave up 4 hits. Both runs were earned. 4 strikeouts and 2 walks. She will see the top of the order again that third time through. Both coaches, you know this. I mean, not, you know, whether it's softball, baseball, whatever. You know that third time through, the numbers start to tilt the hitter's direction. First pitch to Savannah Wysocki from the left-hander is inside for ball one. Wysocki today, 1-for-2. Able to reach base a couple of times. Got a lot of ability on her side. Haygood this year, this is her 6th appearance on the year against Lubbock Christian. As this pitch is rolled to second, Dunkel's got it on to first, one away here in this first inning. But for Madison Haygood, a record of 1-1 in the previous 5 appearances in 23 2/3 innings. She has given up 8 earned runs, but 10 more have been scored on her. 10 strikeouts, 13 walks. Left-hander has started in 4 years for the Oklahoma Christian Eagles. Working to Megan Darling now as that pitch drops in Just a little bit low, it looks like. 1-0. Darling 1-for-2, grounded out to first in the first inning. A single back in inning number 3 to left. Left-hander looks at a pitch. That's in there for a strike. Count evens at 1-1. Lubbock Christian, a couple of left-handers in their order. Trying to see if they can match what their offense has done all year. They have not reached that 7-win plateau very easily, as that is slapped deep in the hole to White at short. Throw on to first, and that is off of the glove of Upton. What a great job by White to get to it and make the play close over there at first. It'll be a base hit for Lubbock Christian's Megan Darling, her second of the game. That ball was absolutely ripped. Strecker couldn't quite glove it with a dive. White with a backhanded play going hard to her right. Had a difficult throw, almost made it. Runner at first with one out. And now Lindsay Klemmer will bat. A walk her last time up as first pitch is outside for ball one. One out. We're in the top of the fifth inning. Two runs, five hits, and an error for Lubbock Christian. Two runs, four hits, and no errors for Oklahoma Christian. Winner trying to claim the automatic berth to the NCAA tournament in Division II. The pitch, that one stays up just a little bit from Madison Haygood on in her first inning of work. Haygood, just her second appearance of this conference tournament. Oklahoma Christian hasn't had to play a lot of games yet. I talked to Coach Shannon Hayes, and he said, yeah, it was nice to rest yesterday, but I'll tell you what, it was nerve-wracking watching the other teams play. And seven games so far, six of them decided by one run, four of them to extra innings. That pitch is low, and that's outside, so a free pass to Lindsay Klemmer. She's aboard for the second time today. Megan Darling will move to second for the Lady Chaps. There is one out, and now Olivia Villarreal will hit. Villarreal, 4 out of 17, make it 5 of 17 in this tournament. Does have 3 RBI and a home run. Today, a single and a run scored back in the second. Facing the left-hander, first pitch is outside, ball one is Madison Haygood. You can tell, wound up pretty good, got the adrenaline flowing, but control is just slightly off right now. Outfield playing very deep here to a talented hitter. And Villarreal, as that pitch called a strike on the outside corner. Count is even at 1-1. Fourth player to bat right here. Wysocki grounded out. Darling and Klemmer have each reached. Darling with a single on the infield to short. The lead runner as the 1-1 pitch is fouled off. That time Villarreal got crossed up a little bit and jammed on the inside part of her bat. Count runs a ball and two strikes. Villarreal's average, you're right at 350. 52 base knocks, 43 runs batted in. That's the top of the team. One home run shy of the team leaders. KK Lopez Liu, who is on deck next. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Hit on the ground to first, and that drifts foul. Lubbock Christian, a team that doesn't hit into a lot of double plays. They have hit into 12 this season. At the top on the other side, Oklahoma Christian, they've turned only 8 double plays. A little bit different for their side of things. They've been a lot better. They have turned to 20 as well, but none yet in this tournament. Ball and two strikes. The pitch swung on, and that's lifted foul as fans trying to duck out of the way. That one leaves the stadium over the first base seats. 1-2 it remains. Villarreal 1-for-2. Looking for her fifth base hit against Oklahoma Christian this season. This is the seventh meeting with the two schools. 4 victories for OC. That pitch is high, and the count will even. 2 balls and 2 strikes. First inning of relief right here for Madison Haygood, the left-hander. trying to settle in. You can tell, again, she's a little bit wired. Been a little bit off on her location, so looks to head coach Shannon Hayes for the pitch. The 2-2 is swung on and fouled off. Haygood's got good movement on her pitches. You know, her two-seamer, when you see it, kind of stays inside. And then the rise ball, real good action to it already. You've seen a couple almost fly over and catch Schultz a little bit off guard. Two balls, two strikes. Darling at second, Clemmer behind at first. Two good players with some speed out there for the Lady Chaps. As the eighth pitch of the at-bat misses. And the count will run full. 3-2. Tenke Lopez Liu is on deck, who is 0-for-1. Haygood looking to the dugout. She's ready. The 3-2 pitch. It's hit on the ground through the right side of the infield. It just missed Clemmer rolling. As the throw comes in, there was no tag applied by Sierra Schultz. And it's 3-2. And Coach Shannon Hayes saying, come on now. As he looked over, if Schultz makes the tag or an attempt at the tag, I think you're getting an out there, quite honestly. But as it goes down, Villarreal will get credit for a single and a run batted in. Her first hit of the day. And her 52nd on the year. And now, Coach Darren Hayes talking with the home plate umpire. In the process, let's see as the umpires might get together. I don't think there was no call made. So let's see here. Darren Hayes talking over there with Coach Brad Everhart, the home plate umpire.
A warning to the coach.
So Coach Darren Hayes has been warned. And it looks like now that Brad Everhart is called the runner out at home. So the home plate umpire, Brad Everhart, again, still making note. I don't know what Coach Hayes is arguing about. Darren was not happy over there at third base. That one, again, everything is all right. He got what he wanted out of it. So it's still 3-2. Lubbock Christian does take the lead as that run did score. And now KK Lopez Liu will bat. One out. Following a warning to the head coach for Lubbock Christian. Lopez Liu now 0-for-1. Got hit by a pitcher first time up as she lays on for the first pitch from Madison Haygood. We're in the top of the fifth inning. Kind of an odd occurrence right there. I don't know what Coach Darren Hayes was not happy about, but he obviously let home plate umpire know about it as the 1-0 delivery looked out. That's inside, and that catches the back of the helmet out there of Lopez Liu. And now looks like timeout is called and going to check on KK. Looks like she's okay. That's the second time she's been hit today. And the bases are full as Darren Hayes is looking at his lineup card. See if he will go and make a change as a pinch runner. Not going to, at least right now. Bases are loaded. Second time here today. Lubbock Christian came up with a hit to drive in two in that second inning. Can they do it here? Darling, the lead runner, is at third. She singled. Lindsey Clemmer at second. And now KK Lopez Liu is at first as Kaylee Arredondo, 0-for-1 today. Looks at the first pitch that's close, but called ball one. Tell you, that pitch at times, again, pitchers, when they've earned the strike zone, have gotten that call. 1-0 the count. That pitch is on the black of the plates. Count evens at 1-1. Arredondo, a strikeout in the third, hit by a pitch back in the second, did not score. Bases loaded, one out, we're in the fifth. Lubbock Christian back in front as this pitch is grounded to first. Here comes the throw home. It's low, but a good job by Schultz to reach out to her right and make the grab for the second out. Fielder's choice for Arredondo, and the bases are still loaded, two outs. That ball was hit hard. Not a great throw by Upton coming home, but got some help in the process, as Megan Darling is the second out. Lindsey Clemmer goes to third. KK Lopez Liu is at second. And now Arredondo, the runner at first, is. It'll be Morgan DeFore with the bases loaded again. One another count. She starts ahead. DeFore drove in two on a base hit up the middle. She walked her last time up, but was caught stealing. Back in the fourth. That's a strike on the outside corner. Count to 1-1. 3-2, Lubbock Christian leading. They need to win twice here today to win the conference title and likely keep their season going. The pitch stays low. It's 2-1, and that's kind of the frustration, but good of this whole thing. You know, somebody's going to continue to play after today. The loser likely will not. The 2-1 pitch is hit in the air well to right, but Denny has room in foul territory along the right field line. She makes the grab, and Lubbock Christian will leave them loaded. That is now seven left aboard for Lubbock Christian, but they do get the run to go ahead 3-2 here in the middle of the fifth inning. This is the 2019 Heartland Conference Softball Tournament Championship Series from San Antonio, Texas. Fifth inning here in San Antonio on campus at St. Mary's University. I'm Andrew Stossmeister. Glad to be with you. Lubbock Christian 3, Oklahoma Christian 2 in this championship series. Lubbock Christian has to win a couple of times if they want to claim the title. Oklahoma Christian needs just one win. They have not lost in this tournament. They're 2-0. Lubbock Christian 3-1. They have had to go and find a way in extra innings twice in this tournament to advance. Right now they hold the advantage as the first pitch is swung on and lifted foul by Bree Dunkel. One strike on the Eagles. Two runs in the second for Lubbock Christian. There was one out there in the last half for their three runs, six hits, and an error they have committed. The error is not factored into the decision. In Oklahoma Christian, they have scored in each of the last two innings, two runs total. They have four hits on the day, no errors. Dunkel one for two, a single and scored back in the third inning. As that pitch is outside from Amber Carlton. Carlton, who started the game, you know, has pitched pretty well, but I'm sure Jordan Weir is going to come in at some point in this game. You know, those two have thrown the entirety of this tournament for the Lady Chaps as the 1-1 is grounded up the middle past a diving Lindsey Clemmer and into center field. Waisaki will chuck it on in to the infield, but a leadoff single for Bree Dunkel. And able to reach here to start this bottom half of inning number five. That is the sixth base hit of the game. Carlton at 62 pitches right now has given up five hits, couple of earned runs, one strikeouts, no walks. And she's done a good job. I think Amber's pitched well. But pressure back on once again. Third time OC has had the leadoff hitter on. Is that his bunted fair? Nope. They're going to say she stepped out and into the field, and everybody goes back, as Hunter Strickland should be out, I think. Shannon Hayes is asking, what was just called? Is Strickland looking up, and they said, I think she must have hit the plate or ran into the ball there going up the line. Strickland is out. Wow. I didn't know. Again, the home plate umpire thought that's what he saw. He was very confident in his call. But Strickland, who ran in and stepped on the plate when she bunted yesterday in a game, called out for a similar situation. One out here in the inning. Here's a bunt try. This is fair. Villarreal Field throws on to first. Two outs. Moving to second is Bree Dunkel. She represents the tying run. So two outs here in this fifth inning. Bridget White on the second sacrifice of the game. So now it's Bridget White. Here's the pitch. That runs inside on... So now a runner at second. Actually, let's go back. Let's check that. Again, they got a new batter up there. Runner at second here in this fifth inning. Pitch is swung on and lined into right field. Bridget White out there. Here comes the throw. It's home. It's off the glove of Darling. And Oklahoma Christian has tied the game. Tied up at three. And pulling into second on the throw is Bridget White. Second base hit for her of the game. And she gets the RBI. Ball was hit well out there. As she will work at second base with one out here in this inning. Hunter Strickland came back and got that sacrifice. And now, Oklahoma Christian looking to take their first lead. Kaylee Upton, 0 for 2, a couple of flyouts here today. She swings and grounds it over to first base. Villarreal will come home and tag out Upton, two outs. So now it'll be left up to Lindsey Stokel with a base runner at third. Shannon Hayes, just as aggressive as Darren. Those two guys are not afraid. You know, the Oklahoma Christian Eagles, they have bunted multiple times here today. At least tried a couple of times. And throughout this season, in big moments. What do you do right here with Lindsey Stokel? A single and a hit by pitch. He has reached twice as she swings and hits the ball in the air to left. It's into the glove of Logan Grotto. And the go-ahead run still at third base as the inning concludes. We head to the sixth inning. We are all tied at three. Each team has six hits. There is one error for Lubbock Christian. What a series here to start this one. The final. Again, a win for Oklahoma Christian. They claim the title. Lubbock Christian has to win twice. This is the 2019 Heartland Conference Softball Championships from San Antonio. Number six here at the 2019 Heartland Conference Championship Series between Lubbock Christian and Oklahoma Christian, all tied up at three. We have had seven games in total so far. This is the eighth. Six of them have been decided by one run. Four of them have gone to extra innings. Two of those games have been played by Lubbock Christian. The only time they didn't have to play that was when they played Oklahoma Christian. Instead, they were walked off in the seventh inning yesterday that allowed the Eagles to get to this game a little bit more fresh. They've only played, this is their third game. This is the fifth of the tournament for Lubbock Christian. Lubbock is 3-1. Oklahoma Christian 2-0. It's a double elimination tournament. 1-0 the count here to lead things off for Lubbock Christians. Logan Grotto, as that pitch is in there for a strike. Grotto 0-2, a strikeout and a fly out to left. Her last time up, she has led off the inning once. The 1-1 pitch. That misses 2-1. Each team with six more outs to work with. The Oklahoma Christian trying to claim their first ever conference tournament championship. They've lost in this series twice, including the last 2 years. Last year was a marathon game as upstart Roger State came out of nowhere as the number five seed to win the tournament. That championship game, the last one for Rogers. They won it in 13 innings as Logan Grotto works a leadoff walk. Alexa Riggs, the scheduled hitter, due up next. As Coach Darren Hayes is looking at his lineup and going to bring somebody out. He's going to bring Anderson out into the game to run. Anderson has typically been the player that has started in Grotto's role. But with Anderson without a hit in eight at-bats in this tournament, tried to go in a different direction. But Anderson will come in to pinch run with nobody out. Anderson on the year does have 12 stolen bases. She's been caught just one time. Madison Haygood in her second inning of relief. Tie game. Lubbock Christian trying to force a second game here in this championship series at the Eagles rally. They will win it and not suffer a loss in this tournament in three games. Also posting what could be their first ever trip to the NCAA Division II tournament. First pitch is on the outside corner, strike one on Alexa Riggs. 0-1, a pop out, tried to bunt last time she was up. Sierra Schultz made a nice play from her catcher position to come out and grab the softball. It was popped up right there at home plate. Here's the 0-1 delivery. This is bunted. It's perfect. Right in front of home to first to throw. Nice play by Sierra Schultz. Retired is Alexa Riggs. That is a successful sacrifice. One out. And a runner, Anderson, in scoring position now at second. Perfect bunt right in front of home plate. You know, that's, again, another big nuance to softball. The field's smaller. You bunt it really anywhere forward, and it turns out to be pretty good. You're not necessarily trying to drag for a bunt there in a sacrifice situation. And now you got the strength of the order coming up. Savannah Wysocki, 1-for-3 here today from the left side. First pitch to Wysocki is high, ball one. Madison Haygood tossing. She came into the game. She was behind a run. Her team has since tied it up a couple of times. That pitch is on the outside corner. Good heat on that shot. Ball and two strikes. Or 1-1, excuse me. Anderson at second. Wind's blowing in slightly right now. Sunny day in San Antonio. Haygood delivers. This pitch is hit back to the circle. Haygood fields. Look out. It's high, but a good stretch over there by Upton. Helps to be a taller player at first base on a throw that was a little bit high. The pivot foot for Haygood slid. It does move Anderson to third base as the go-ahead run, as Wysocki is retired. Two outs. So now it'll be Megan Darling looking for a two-out hit. None of those yet for Lubbock Christian, trying to find that two-out RBI. First pitch is down and inside, ball one. Lubbock Christian, the team that has led in this game. They went out 2-0 in the second. They were tied after we went to the fifth. Now see, Lubbock Christian pulled ahead by one before the Eagles tied it up again at three. Lady Chaps trying to score for the third time in the last five innings. First two out of the zone on Megan Darling, who was 2 for 3, singles in each of her last at-bats. She came around to score, got cut down at the plate her last time up. The 2-0 pitch. That's on the middle of the plate for a strike. Right there at the knees. 2-1. Lubbock Christian trying to force a second championship game. Go ahead, run at third. The 2-1 delivery is lifted foul. Anderson, again, a good runner over there at third base. Obviously puts into play the wild pitch. Haygood on the year has been all right at that, but it's one of the things that you never know. Again, pressure situations. 6 wild pitches for Madison Haygood this season. 2-2. Darling the hitter. Haygood looks to the dugout. She's ready. The 2-2 pitch is outside, and the count is full at 3 balls and 2 strikes. Lindsey Clemmer on deck for Lubbock Christian if she gets the chance. Anderson at third base. After Logan Grotto's position walked, Anderson came into pinch run, moved over on a sacrifice, and then a ground out to the circle. The 3-2 is popped up shallow left. Long run for everybody, but it's Lindsey Stokel who reaches over ahead of her to make the grab waist high for the third out of the inning. A runner left at third base for Lubbock Christian. They did not have any hits. Middle of 6, tied at 3 between the Lady Chaps and the Eagles of Oklahoma Christian in this championship series of the 2019 Heartland Conference Softball Tournament from San Antonio, Texas. Inning number 6 here from San Antonio, Texas, in this 2019 Heartland Conference Championship Series of the Double Elimination Softball Tournament. The number 3 seed, Roger State, went out first. Then it was the number 1 and top seeded host at St. Mary's next. Behind them, Texas A&M International, the Dust Devils. Part of what has been a real competitive tournament. Only one game not decided by a run. There have been 4 extra inning games. Oklahoma Christian and Lubbock Christian meeting for the second time in this tournament as this pitch is hit into the air into right center field. Arredondo up with it. Oklahoma Christian's Kayla Eichler has her first hit of the game. And she is aboard. She represents the go-ahead run for the Oklahoma Christian Eagles. OC has never made it to the Division II NCAA tournament. Flirting with the idea right now. They need to win once. As Shannon Hayes, the Heartland Conference Coach of the Year, will go and get a pinch runner. It'll be Sydney Smith to run. She represents the go-ahead run for Oklahoma Christian. Smith has scored a run in this tournament. She has stolen 3 bases. As now it's going to be the pitching change for head coach Darren Hayes. He will go ahead and get Jordan Weir. Jordan Weir making her 5th appearance of this Heartland Conference tournament. Pitching in all 5 games. She has started twice, 2-0 with her record. She does also have a save. 10 innings tossed for the right-hander. He's got 6 strikeouts, 6 walks, 8 earned runs. And he wondered a little bit about how Lubbock Christian, how they would do with their pitching count, at least as that was sitting. Weir throwing 204 pitches in the previous couple of days. Amber Carlton, with as she finishes this game, with 68. Takes her to 292 for the tournament. It's pretty impressive right there. Nobody out. The leadoff base runner aboard for the Eagles of Oklahoma Christian. Sydney Smith at first. The hitter is Sierra Schultz, who has an RBI and a double in the game. See if Schultz is bunting right here. Schultz does not have a sacrifice this season. Infield back for the most part. Now coming in as Schultz showed bunt and laid off. It's outside 1-0 the count. DeFore and Villarreal were both playing even at the bag and charged late as the bunt was shown. The outfield is deep. Schultz has hit the ball well all year. And through injuries, we've talked about as the 1-0 is popped up on the infield, rigs the shortstop in left, calls for it. Instead, Anderson, who stays in the game, comes in and makes the grab, one out. You know, that was, again, you look at it for Coach Shannon Hayes about what's going on, and he is going over there to Sierra saying, you know, that's a good idea, but she was out in front trying to lift that ball over the fence. Probably wanted to see it on the ground is what the coach was talking about. So one out. And now it'll be Daylin Denny looking for her first hit in 3 trips. She slaps it just to first. That almost serves as a bunt. Great job, move the runner over. Villarreal with a nice throw on to first base. 2 outs. Though as it becomes. That is goofy. I almost wonder if you give that as a sacrifice. Go ahead, run it second. 2 outs to work with. And now the hitter is Bailey Strecker. First pitch on the outside corner for a strike. Bailey Strecker, 2 flyouts today, 0 for 2 officially. Strecker with 35 base hits, 29 runs driven in. 2 of those in this tournament. The pitch misses away, count is even at 1-1. Jordan Weir, the 1-1 delivery on the inside corner, strike 2. Jordan Weir taking over for Amber Carlton. Facing now her third batter. She's gotten 2 outs. Runner at second. The 1-2 pitch. Nubbed foul towards the first base side with Lubbock Christians. Darren Hayes looking on, seeing if his team can get out of the jam. Each team is threatened throughout. Oklahoma Christian, a run in 3 straight innings, trying to push ahead and look for 3 outs to win the championship. Work to do, obviously, with that, with a base runner at second. Smith standing there, can move. The 1-2. Swing and a miss. It is strike 3. Throw on down to first. And that will end the threat. Jordan Weir does what she's supposed to. She comes in and gets 3 straight outs as Sydney Smith stranded at second. We go to the 7th inning. We're all tied at 3. What a game here in this championship series. A win for Oklahoma Christian and their champs. Lubbock Christian trying to force game number 2. This is the 2019 Heartland Conference Softball Tournament Championship Series from San Antonio, Texas.
No trouble with me. Trying to keep it peaceful is a struggle for me. Don't pull up this thing, say, I'm a part of me. You know how I like it when you love it on me. I put in a mess for you. Things that they wish. Got some brothers that I live with. I feel good sometimes, I don't, baby. I feel It's a lot of bad things that they listen
to. And now coming back into the pitch is Crandall.
Start of inning number 7. We're in San Antonio, Texas at St. Mary's University at the park. Good to have you with us here for this 8th game of the tournament. If the Eagles win, they will be the champions. If Lubbock wins, we're going to play again here about 30 minutes after the conclusion of this game. The Eagles have never won this tournament. Lubbock Christian has won it twice. Back into the game, tossing is Callie Crandall, who started the game. One of those beautiful rules of softball, you can leave, come back in there. Crandall has tossed 4 innings worth. She gets 3, 4, and 5 in the order. Lindsey Clemmer first, who has walked the last 2 times, spun out of the way of that one. That was in there. Coach Darren Hayes said, hey, come on, we need base runners. 0-for-1 officially. She has walked each of the last 2 times up. Crandall ready. The pitch is hit in the air towards right field. Daylin Denny in foul ground reaches up. She makes the grab. That's the first out here of the 7th inning. 3 runs, 6 hits, 1 error for Lubbock Christian. 2 in the second for their runs. And then 1 in the 5th. Oklahoma Christian a run in the 3rd, 4th, and 5th. They have 7 hits. They have not committed an error in the game. That is the 6th flyout of the game for Lubbock Christian. They have grounded out 7 times. The Eagles have a 2-out RBI as well that pulled them back even. That's first pitch on the outside corner for a strike to Olivia Villarreal. 1, make it 2-for-3 on the day. Single and an RBI or less time up to bring in a run. Here's the 1-0. One is inside, almost caught Villarreal. There have been some hit-by-pitches here today. We're trying to find ways to get on base. The name of the game right now. Lubbock Christian with the bases empty here in the 7th. Tie game. The 2-0. Hit back over the circle, and that is past the freshman into center field. And Villarreal will be aboard with 1 out. Tell you, that's one of the things that, you know, Coach Shannon Hayes and I have talked about throughout this season, is that he really doesn't feel like, you know, that Crandall has been real comfortable in the circle, especially as a fielder. That's why Haygood started yesterday's game with eventually Callie Crandall finishing. And now, again, just didn't really react quick enough to have a chance at it. It wasn't hit real hard, but certainly a well-placed softball. As Coach Darren Hayes looking at his lineup card and looking like he will get Anderson to come over there and pinch run. Or, I'm sorry, it'll be Mariah Garza who will come in and run. Anderson, who is already moved into the game, came into pinch run and stayed in left field. Outfield very deep right now to KK Lopez Liu. 7 long balls, couple of doubles in this tournament. Has been hit by a pitch twice in 3 at-bats. First pitch is over the plate for a strike to the senior, the designated player here today. Has 3 hits in this tournament. As mentioned, 2 of them are extra base knocks. A couple of RBI. The 0-1. Upstairs, count even at 1 ball and 1 strike. Oklahoma Christian, 37-14, looking to steal the automatic berth from this tournament. They were ranked 10th in the region rankings, the only other team from the Heartland ranked besides St. Mary's. As that changeup in there for strike 2, 1-2. Oklahoma Christian in the final. The last 2 years, they have not been able to win. 2 years ago, Lubbock Christian defeated them. A ball and 2 strikes, runner at first. Garza represents the go-ahead run. The 1-2 is lifted to shallow left. Long run as Stokel slides in and makes the grab. 2 outs. Now, she has made a couple of impressive grabs here on the day for Oklahoma Christian in left field. As she comes up with that for the second out of the inning, now it's Kaylee Arredondo Seeking out her first hit, officially 0 for 2. Got hit by a pitch in the second, also reached in the fifth on a fielder's choice. Base runner at first, two outs, top of the seventh in a tie game. First offering from the freshman Crandall is popped up to first. Long run as it's over the outstretched arms of Upton in foul territory near the dirt of the track. One strike. Wind straight down at the ground, slightly lifting up. Again, hasn't been much of a factor. It's been a sunny day today in the 70s in San Antonio, unlike overcast and some rain the last 2 days of this tournament. Crandall, the freshman. The 0-1 delivery is lined into center field. Strickland plays it on a hop. She'll chuck it in. Stopping at second is Garza. And now, runners at first and second, two outs for Morgan DeFore, as Coach Darren Hayes will bring the group in. Hope you've had as much fun as we have here at the 2019 Heartland Conference Softball Championships. It's been a lot of fun to watch these five teams that have all been here. Looks like Shannon Hayes is on his way out to the circle, wants to talk some strategy. Darren doing the same thing with his three girls right now. Yesterday, Oklahoma Christian walked off after the game was tied heading into the bottom of the seventh inning. Got a leadoff base runner and a game-winning hit. Situation might be possible. Lubbock Christian trying to tip the odds in their favor. Had a fly out to right field to begin this inning. And then a single up the middle by Villarreal, replaced by Garza as a pinch runner, who is at second base right now. And then you get another runner at first. I mean, things are very possible as Kaylee Arredondo reached. Morgan DeFore, the base runner, or base hit, the hitter right now. Officially 1 for 2. The pitch, soft stuff, stays over the plate. In between a couple of singles, a couple of flyouts here in this seventh inning. Garza represents the go-ahead run. She's at second. Arredondo behind at first as that pitch off speed in there for a strike. 2-1. Callie Crandall being very careful right here. Again, started the game through four innings. Replaced by Madison Haygood for two. Now back in here in the seventh. This, her 99th pitch, is popped up foul to the backstop, and the count will even up at 2-2. Lubbock Christian, a player they love having right here. Most people's teams, you take her as a three or a four hitter. Lubbock Christian, she's kind of slid down and really handled the role here at somewhere between 6 and 9. She's hitting seventh here today. Two RBI in the game. The 2-2 swung on and missed strike three. What a time for a punch out for Callie Crandall. Her fifth of the game. Two are left aboard for Lubbock Christian. We head to the bottom of the seventh. Oklahoma Christian looking for the walk-off here in this championship game. We'll see if they can do it next or if we'll go to the extra innings for the fifth time this weekend at the 2019 Heartland Conference Championships. This is the championship series from San Antonio, Texas. I'm gonna let it down. bottom of the seventh inning here in San Antonio, Texas, of this championship round of the 2019 Heartland Conference Softball Tournament. Andrew Stotzmeister back. The Oklahoma Christian Eagles have the top of their order up, trying to win their first ever Heartland Conference Championship and punch a ticket to their first ever NCAA Division II tournament. We'll see if they can do that. They need a run against Jordan Weir, who came on in the last half inning. First pitch is outside, ball one. Bree Dunkel, 2-for-3 today. Jordan Weir, pretty fresh right now with 8 pitches. Pitched yesterday and has been busy in this tournament with 5 appearances. She has not lost yet as this pitch is popped up. Trying to lay out for it as a 4. Can't get to it in time. Count evens at 1-1. KK Lopez Liu will check into the game from the designated player role. Going to play some first base right now as DeFore getting rearranged and settled back in. Outside of that, Anderson came in earlier. She's in the outfield with Wysocki and Arredondo. For Riggs, Clemmer, and Lopez Liu now on the infield. Darnley still behind home plate. The hitter, Bree Dunkel. Bottom of the seventh, tie game of this championship series. That pitch is on the corner for a strike. 1-2. Oklahoma Christian 37-14. Lubbock Christian 32-18. Oklahoma Christian ranked 10th in the South Central region. The top 8 teams will get in. Automatic berths to the 3 league winners. The 1-2. And that was quite the pitch by Jordan Weir. Came in and Darling almost put it over the inside part of the plate for strike 3. Couldn't quite get it, but a great idea. Tell you what, it certainly surprised Bree Dunkel. Jordan Weir back out there, the junior. As she delivers, that pitch is low and away. And that will run the count full. 3 balls and 2 strikes. Lubbock Christian has not issued a walk yet. And now going over to Chet is Bree Dunkel with Coach Shannon Hayes here briefly. Coach Hayes said he was nervous before the game. Says it doesn't happen to him a whole lot until the stakes get to typically about this point. Most guys are like that, gals as well. You know, just the whole point of, you know, you get coaches that are nervous in this particular moment. Tell you what, I don't know about Darren Hayes, how he's feeling. You know, he wasn't nervous before the game, but he said, hey, you know, probably we'll see how it goes. Come see me after it's over. 3 balls and 2 strikes. The payoff pitch is lined. It's off the glove of Weir up the middle. And Bree Dunkel is aboard here to start the bottom of the seventh inning. Base hit number 7 in the game. Or number 8 will it be? Regardless, Bree Dunkel's out there. And now let's see where Hunter Strickland will try to bunt. Keep an eye on this. Again, Strickland has done this. Did this last time she was up. Can't step on the plate. Can't run into it in front of home plate. That's hard for a sweeper to just regular bunt. DeFore is playing 10 feet in front of third. Here's the pitch. It's bunted, and that catches Hunter Strickland in the field of play. She is out. And she's frustrated. That's the whole part of the problem with the drag, you know, that you look at. When you have a sweeper, you're already going out of the box. And you just say, hey, can you turn around? The senior couldn't quite execute. She's out. So one out. Dunkel still at first. Remember, Bree Dunkel can run, folks. 22 stolen bases on the season. Would she go right here? First pitch is down and in. Darling able to hold up as she looked out towards second base. 1-0 the count. Darling has tossed out 7 base runners this season as this ball is slowly hit to the shortstop, Riggs, who doesn't have a play. Everybody is safe. Everyone safe on that play for Bridget White, who has her 3rd hit of the game. What a deal right there. And now The go-ahead, the championship-winning run at second base with an out for Oklahoma Christian. Not hit real hard, but Bridget White doing a good job as she sets it up for Kaylee Upton for Oklahoma Christian. One out. Infield playing the hole on the right side. Lopez Liu is in front of the base. First pitch from Jordan Weir is inside for ball one. Talk about leaning on a player that can handle some pressure, Kaylee Upton. The senior in her 52nd game here today. Three-year starter for the Eagles. 1-0 pitch is outside, ball two. Upton again, a first-team all-conference performer, leads the team and runs batted in. She's got 44 of them. Upton looking for her first of this tournament. Pitch swung on and hit in the air, but it is foul at first base. That'll get up and into the seats. Two balls and a strike here with an out in this bottom of the seventh inning. Bree Dunkel, the base runner at second, represents the game-winning run. Jordan Weir trying to extend it to our fifth extra inning game of this tournament. Runs for Oklahoma Christian in the third, fourth, and fifth inning. Got nine hits. 2-1 delivery is upstairs. Ball three. Lindsey Stokel is on deck. RBI today. White has two of them. Schultz has the other. She had the walk-off hit yesterday for the Eagles against Lubbock Christian. 2-1 victory. We're tied at three. Jordan Weir looking in at Darling. The 2-1 pitch is down and in. Ball four. Holy cow. Bases loaded here in the bottom of the seventh inning. Dunkel moves to third. Bridget White to second. And now Jordan Weir faces Lindsey Stokel. Outfield is still very deep. Darren Hayes looking down at the look, and now he's going to bring everybody in. He's looking out to Anderson, trying to get her attention. You know, the ball goes out to where she's at. That's going to be a problem. Yeah, Anderson has good arm. Wysocki probably the best of the outfielders. And now Lindsey Stokel with the championship run at third. Tie game, bottom of the seventh as Jordan Weir winds and delivers. That's in the dirt. Good block by Darling. Stokel, a base hit back in the fourth, got hit by a pitch in the second, is officially one for two. Stokel, the former player at Oklahoma State, as the 1-0 bounce to third, it is foul as DeFore crosses the line of play and fields it, but a foul ball. Count is even, 1-1. The bases are loaded for Oklahoma Christian. Not many of these here throughout. They have left six on base today. Lubbock Christian, 21 double plays. Keep that in the back of your mind, too. The 1-1 delivery bounces. Good block again by Darling. 2-1. One out in the bottom of the seventh. Oklahoma Christian 60 feet away from winning their first ever conference championship in the Heartland. They have lost each of the last two seasons. The 2-1. Hit on the ground. That is foul. Heading towards the dugout over there for the Eagles. They are the home team here in this game. Two balls and two strikes. Eichler would be up next if she gets a chance. Lindsey Stokel, a chance to win it. Jordan Weir, the junior, trying to extend the game. The 2-2. Hit on the ground. Weir's got it to home for one. On to first. Not in time. They say she is safe. Holy cow. What a great throw by Darling. Fielder's choice. And the game keeps going. That was a very close play. And as that looked like it happened, it certainly looked like she was out by a step in real time. No replay, nothing like that. And now here comes Coach Darren Hayes. He cannot believe it. He is just talking to see what he saw. Unbelievable. Dunkel is out at home for the second out of the inning. Bridget White still at third, Upton at second, and Stokel at first. There are two outs, and Coach Darren Hayes comes up. He cannot believe it. He wants to bring everybody in right now. Unbelievable. Man, you needed a play. Jordan Weir nearly gave it to you. So two outs.
Number 24 got an unsportsmanlike conduct warning.
So they get a unsportsmanlike is what they call. I love it, Christians. Kaylee Arredondo, who was in right field, I guess, and shouted something that maybe you're not supposed to do. Tell you what, Annette Bergman's had a couple of really tough calls.
Hey, you gotta keep fighting.
So they will get the opportunity for Kayla Eichler, who comes up with two outs back into the game. Eichler struck out back in inning number two for Oklahoma Christian. Officially 1-for-2 in the game with that single that she had earlier today. Holy cow, two outs, bottom of the seventh, tie game of this championship series of the Heartland Conference as the first pitch is outside, ball one. 1-0 the count. Jordan Weir with a walk in the inning. Bases are loaded. 1-0 is hit a long way foul. That'll even the count up at 1-1. Bree Dunkel reached to open the inning, got cut down at home just moments ago. Strickland tried to sacrifice and ran into the softball in fair territory. She was called out. Dunkel had to go back to first. Eventually moved up as Bridget White singled on the infield. The 1-1. After White singled, Kaylee Upton walked. That brought up Lindsey Stokel, who just hit into the fielder's choice. Right back to the circle. Two balls and a strike on Kayla Eichler. Championship run 60 feet away at third. Jordan Weir with a 2-1 pitch that gets to the backstop, and Oklahoma Christian is going to win their first Heartland Conference Championship on a walk-off wild pitch. Unbelievable. That was something else right there, folks. Lubbock Christian not happy. Their season will conclude at 32-19. They were not ranked in the South Central Region rankings. It's not to say that it's completely over, but how about Oklahoma Christian? Shannon Hayes in his first year. Can tell he's holding back some emotion right now as teams are going to shake hands. He wins the final conference championship here in 2019 for the Oklahoma Christian Eagles. They will qualify for the first time ever for the NCAA Division II tournament. It will be announced on Monday. Lubbock Christian can wait and see, but hugs and whatnot going back and forth between players and coaches on both sides. What a game. Jordan Weir will finish on the losing side of this game. His players shaking hands, and Shannon and Darren are going to go and talk to one another and bring Oklahoma Christian together. I'll tell you what, I wouldn't be surprised. I know it's not against it, but everybody going to get together and probably say some things as they get ready to do this. But I wouldn't be surprised, you know, as close as Darren and Shannon are, if Darren ended up winding up going with Shannon again out there to the NCAA tournament. What a game, folks. What a game. Walk-off wild pitch. As it goes down, ball in the dirt from Jordan Weir's. Darling couldn't block it, and right now, both teams sharing a moment. A lot of love out there. It looks like they're having a prayer right now. The winning pitcher gets to be Callie Crandall. for Oklahoma Christian. 16th victory on the season. Nice special moment out there in the middle of the circle for these two teams. You got players mixed in and out. That doesn't give you goosebumps. I don't know what will. On the offensive side of things for Oklahoma Christian, Dunkel and White, both out there with three hits. White had two runs batted in. Bridget White scores the game-winning run. Coming in to score, Stokel, Eichler, and Schultz all had hits. Sierra Schultz had the other RBI and double, as did Bridget White. For Lubbock Christian, they were led today by Olivia Villarreal, who had three hits. Darling had two. Wysocki, the freshman of the year, finishes 1-for-4. Arredondo, 1-for-3. The senior, Morgan DeFore, 1-for-3. 2 RBI. And perhaps her final collegiate softball game. Final score, walk-off style, Oklahoma Christian 4. Lubbock Christian 3. We're so happy that we have had you with us here for the 2019 Heartland Conference Championships. Of course, a big thanks out to St. Mary's for hosting. I want to thank Heather Kennedy. She's been helping out here. She's done a lot of good for me and helping out here with all of these broadcasts throughout this season. I'm Andrew Stossmeister. What a fun time here. We'll have the trophy presentation. We'll have it still going, but we're going to let it roll back there as they get a chance to hand out all the softballs. I'll tell you what, if you like the Heartland Conference, you better tune in next weekend. Baseball is going to be a riot next week with four teams that will be playing. We look forward to watching that as it all goes down to the wire. What a tournament, folks. There were eight games, seven of them decided by one run. Your final, Oklahoma Christian. In their 38th victory of the season, they win their first Heartland Conference title. They will be looking to see if they can find a way to win some NCAA tournament games. And I'll tell you what, I think there's absolutely a very good opportunity. What a tournament. We'll let you watch. I'm Andrew Stossmeister. It's been a lot of fun, folks. Enjoy the rest of this trophy presentation here in San Antonio, Texas at the 2019 Heartland Conference Championships.
Park at St. Mary's University. This Heartland Conference tournament has had it all. Sliding catches, diving catches, clutch home runs, and even a triple play. Before we get started with the pregame announcement, let's give all the teams a big hand. This has been a great tournament.
Shannon Hayes from Oklahoma.
last year, the Heartland